We have raised these same issues in the last 1.5 months in writing, in a delegation of the Congress, in delegations combined of the Congress, TDP and other parties. Now, we asked the EC, why have they not responded? Well, strangely, although the EC has heard us for almost an hour, they are saying now, they assured us, that they will meet again tomorrow morning to consider primarily these two issues. The second point we made was that even if you, the EC, disagrees with us, there is nothing to disagree. It is a very small, simple thing, which is a confidence-building measure. But if you disagree with us also, if 75% of the electorate represented by these 22 parties is before you, how does it matter if you change the rules, which is not even a rule change, it is merely a change of the guidelines, the procedure, that you count first? I think this is, if I may use that phrase with great respect, a no-brainer. And the Election Commission has not decided it for 6 weeks. They are now saying that they will again meet tomorrow. The second point is that if a glass of milk by a sample as they say is supposed to be a subset of the universe, if a subset of the universe, a sample, is found poisoned, as the Supreme Court says, in 5 sample checks you find a discrepancy between the VVPAT and the EVM, then it is obvious that the universe which that sample represents is vitiated. So it is obvious that if a sample check, what is the purpose of a sample check by the Supreme Court? The purpose of a sample check is to see whether the whole universe is vitiated. If the sample finds it to be vitiated by discrepancies, why should you not count 100% of VVPATs? We are only asking for a counting of 100% of VVPATs. And remember, 9,000 crores was spent to ensure that one EVM has one corresponding VVPAT. This also happened over a 3 years campaign. Why should you have these VVPATs as decorative, ornamental pieces and not count them after finding a sample problem?